First off, we're going to see the women's singles. First, we have Jiaqi Zheng.
Jiaqi Zheng came over here from China about 7 years ago, got her citizenship. She's the current women's national champion. She is going to go against Lily Zhang, her teammate, champion 2 years ago, who's trying to regain supremacy of the United States.
And in this match, she'll be playing Lily Zhang.
Lily Zhang playing out of the ICC Table Tennis Center in Milipitas, California. She's been a multiple-time national champion. She is current Olympian. She is very decorated. She's won the youth, or got a bronze medal in the Youth Olympic Games. Now, we are going to see if she can regain her title in America as the U.S. Women's National Champion.
So both players are ready to go. We're going to get a chance to get to see the top two women both heading over to Rio for a chance to go for gold tonight. Corey, here we have what to watch for in this match. First up, Lily Zhang.
Lily Zhang, Sean, she knows what it's like to be in these moments. She has got to get to the middle of Jiaqi Zheng. If she does not, she is going to be in a lot of trouble. The other thing she's going to have to do is really extend the rallies. The longer the rally goes, I believe the advantage goes to Lily Zhang.
And on the other side of the net, we've got Jiaqi Zheng. What does she need to look for?
She has got to control the short game first and foremost, and she's got to be confident in her forehand hit. That is where she has to lean on. Also, one last thing for Jiaqi. She has experience playing in the Brooklyn Bowl and great memories here. She won the title here last year.
Of course, this will be a best of seven match. Games to 11, win by two.
One thing, Sean, you can see early on, Jiaqi Zheng is really making it a focus to keep playing the short forehand of Lily Zhang, and you're going to see her continually try to do that throughout the match.
So it looked like Lily Zhang in the black shirt thought it was a net serve. The umpires have signaled yes indeed, so they will replay the point. Very powerful forehand by Jiaqi. Known with that penholder grip, she has a pips out type of rubber on her forehand side, which allows her to hit it very fast. On the backhand side, she has smooth for heavy spin. Corey, how critical would you say this first game is in this best of seven match?
For Lily, I think she's just trying to get into the match a little bit. She's never played here at the Brooklyn Bowl. She doesn't have as much experience in this arena particularly. So I think for Lily, it would be a great start if she could get some confidence under her. But I think right now we're still in a feeling out process, and I don't think this game is absolutely crucial to winning the match.
And these players did play recently in the 2016 North American Olympic Trials, where Lily was victorious. Of course, Jiaqi, the defending women's champion. A very powerful smash by Jiaqi that sends the ball past the expensive seats into some of the lesser expensive. And she now has built a 6-2 lead.
Sean, she has really built that lead, continually going to the short forehand of Lily Zhang.
Both these players have tremendous backhand attacks, just really not giving an inch, but going toe-to-toe, backhand-to-backhand, then finally one will play it out to the wide forehand side. Once again, Jiaqi Zheng just powering through that backhand.
You can see Sean there, Jiaqi really trying to change the tempo, going with some high, slow spin. Lily popping that ball up a little bit, and Jiaqi coming in with the flat hit.
Beautiful play by Lily, able to get her backhand in. That ball was played to the middle, Corey, but somehow Lily was able to step over and play that ball wide out to the forehand. Players will hit the ball. The previous ball went into the stands. It looks like one lucky spectator was able to keep it as a souvenir. So they started with a new ball. They did a little warm up. Now Lily Zhang to serve, trailing 4-7 in game one. Now Lily getting a slight upper hand in those backhand-to-backhand exchanges.
Yeah, Sean, like I said in the beginning, the longer the rally goes, even though it hasn't happened that way so far, Lily will have the slight advantage in the longer rallies. One thing she has to continually try to do with her backhand is find the middle of Jiaqi.
Jiaqi going for a very strong third ball attack. Unable to lift that heavy underspin push by Lily Zhang. Lily with the serve.
And Sean, that serve by Lily leaked out long. Jiaqi should have been looking for that. Whenever you're feeling out each other in the first kind of moments, there's some nerves. And when there's nerves, the serves usually go off the end, and that's when you have to look to attack. That one's long too, yep.
It looked like Jiaqi was a little bit safe with her opening shot. Lily jumping right on top of it.
And Sean, it's a really great tactic by Lily to serve a little bit longer, because then Jiaqi can't drop shot and exploit Lily's short forehand. So I think Lily is happy to have Jiaqi open if it's as long as it's soft, if it means that she doesn't have to play a lot of short forehands.
And Lily gets to game point, now leading 10-8, and she will have the serve, able to really control that first backhand opening loop by Jiaqi. Again, backhand to backhand exchanges, catching the edge of Jiaqi's racket. Now two game points for Lily Zhang. That was one heck of a forehand smash directly off the serve. Didn't look like the ball was that high, but Jiaqi just jumped on top of it. One game point saved. And Lily tries to duplicate the same shot, but is unsuccessful. And we are now at deuce, 10 all. Serves will alternate. Winner must gain an advantage by two. Jiaqi with the serve. Let's see if she goes with the high toss or she stays with the low toss. Net serve. And Lily, very strong table presence there, able to withstand Jiaqi's very strong forehand opening. And once again, now with her third game point. Jiaqi, once again, controlling that short ball like you mentioned earlier, Corey, not giving Lily anything to work with.
And I expect Lily to push out on this serve return, Sean. Look to open up the point and rally.
Oh, what a tremendous forehand counterattack. Jiaqi with a nice serve, got the opening, went for the kill. Lily somehow managed to keep her body moving forward and killed it to the open cross court. Game point number four. And these players, Corey, are just neck and neck. Both so offensive-minded. It looks like Lily's willing to put the game on her back and just really go for it.
A little bit of a tactical mistake there, Sean, by Jiaqi, in my opinion. She should be trying to keep Lily serve short. Wow, a quick timeout here by Lily Zhang. So I was wrong about the importance of the first game, Sean. Clearly Lily thinks this game is really important. She's already not capitalized on the first couple game points she's had. She just wants to settle down. I think she overplayed a little bit her first couple game points, and I think it's just a reminder that your normal shots are good enough. Pick a good location and go with it.
Again, each player is allowed one timeout per match. This is a best of seven. So Lily is expending that first one-minute break early on in this match. Jiaqi will be able to hold hers off, whether it's she wants to use in this game or any time. Of course, there's no use in saving them after the match is over. No trading them in. So Lily really focusing right now. You can see she's taking the full one-minute.
And there's no coaching, Sean. There's U.S. versus U.S. They're both teammates, so we don't allow any coaching. They're playing this match on their own, so it is kind of interesting. Usually they have a coach calling a timeout for them, but now they're on their own. 13-12.
And that timeout yielded great results there for Lily Zhang as she takes game number one, 14-12 in dramatic fashion. Haven't seen a timeout in the first game, Corey, in ages.
Yeah, and this is the thing you're gonna see out of Lily Zhang. She has more power than Jiaqi has. But is Jiaqi gonna let Lily get into her power game? Is she gonna try to keep her short? Lily made a lot more tactical changes that game than Jiaqi did, and that's why she stormed back from 8-5 all the way to 10-8.
And of course, we've seen a number of rule changes, Corey, in the last 15 years, starting with an increase in ball size. A lot of people don't realize, but we actually bumped it up to 40 millimeters. Of course, we've changed the scoring from 21 to 11, more games per match instead of 3 out of 5. We now play best 4 out of 7. There's been some other issues that are coming up.
So in 2016, there's actually coaching allowed between the points, and that starts in October. So we have had a lot of changes coming along, and we have more on the way, it looks like.
Always trying to make the game more exciting for the spectator and the viewer. There was that short return that you mentioned, Corey, that Jiaqi in the red shirt was able to deliver, but Lily had an answer. She was able to flip that ball back.
Yeah, that's the smart play for Lily. Just get the ball out, start the rally, and continue the rally.
Oh, there's the powerful forehand of Jiaqi Zhang, just taking that ball right off the bounce, the backhand to the forehand. Wow, that is just lightning quick. Very strong play on both sides. Lily able to get her backhand attack going. Jiaqi got jammed a little bit there, but finally, one more shot to the body.
You could see she got jammed there, Sean, because Lily got a good ball right into her middle. Caused her to play kind of a weak shot.
That was a nice drop shot there by Jiaqi. It seems to really allow her to control that first opening, whether it's on the backhand with topspin or on the forehand when she drives it a little bit more with the flat hit. Oh, and there's a powerful backhand over the table. Not only can Jiaqi smash on the forehand side, but here's a snapping backhand. Really catching Lily looking. Jiaqi with the serve, leading 4-3 in this game, but trailing 1-0.
Big point there for Jiaqi, Sean, to get the 2-point advantage and to feel like she's coming back in the match a little bit. Then that time Jiaqi got to Lily's middle. That's the most difficult shot in table tennis to deal with, is when an opponent puts a quality shot at your counterpoint between your backhand and your forehand. It is so hard to deal with that ball.
And once again, Lily rising to the occasion with a nice third ball attack of her own. That big forehand cross court, table 9-5, but still a lot of area to aim for. That is just pure power. Jiaqi's on high toss serve, has to play one quick backhand, but quickly stepping around the ball to the middle.
And Sean, how she got the high ball was she got that ball into the middle of Lily. Lily gave an easy ball. She stepped around and pounded the forehand. Really good heads up table tennis by Jiaqi.
It looked like she was maybe going for a little bit of a misdirection there down the line.
Yeah, and that push sat up. She should have hit that ball. Of course, this game is really easy sitting here in the booth with you. A little more difficult when you're out there in the action, playing for the most important title in U.S. table tennis.
That is just too much topspin, backhand to backhand. Jiaqi set it up. Lily went for the opening, quick off the bounce, and then Lily off the bounce to her own backhand. Was able to find a narrow margin wide to Jiaqi's backhand. And we are back to even, 7-7. Jiaqi with the serve. Again, she's been mixing up the lower toss and the high toss serve. Oh, that is one beautiful forehand smash. Jiaqi mixing it up there with a much deeper serve. Lily able to deal with ball right into her body. And again, these players have just been neck and neck throughout this first game and a half. Lily with the serve.
A little bit of a miss hit that time. It came off the edge of Lily's racket. You can see right. Not that one. That one that went down the line, it just clipped the edge of her racket, so the ball came off a little funny. Lily scores, has the 9-8 lead. Oh, great misdirection shot by Lily. The same shot she scored on Sean to win the last game gets her the crucial two-point advantage. And another two game points here in game two.
Just a mirror image of what we saw the previous game, Lily not giving an inch. And Lily takes game number two with an error by Jiaqi. So right now, players will go to their corners, but they will not have any additional coaching as they're generally used to. Both players really mixing it up. Jiaqi's final smash into the net. Point to Lily Zhang, who now leads 2-0. Welcome back to the 2016 U.S. National Table Tennis Championships, sponsored by Supermicro at the Brooklyn Bowl. My name is Sean O'Neill, along with Corey Eider. Corey, we're now in game three with Jiaqi Zheng in the red top playing against Lily Zhang. Right now, Lily has been controlling the action.
Yeah, Sean, the first two games, Jiaqi's had decent leads the whole way through, and then at the end, Lily seems to pull it out. This game is do or die for Jiaqi. If she doesn't win this game, it's going to be almost impossible to win four games in a row against an opponent the quality of Lily Zhang.
Again, Corey, these players met in the Olympic trials in North America this year. We saw Jiaqi blast out of the blocks there and win 4-0. Do you see any similarities between that match and this one?
No, I don't, Sean. That match was won by one tactic that Jiaqi strictly didn't have an answer for. But the match is going completely different. That match was all Lily Zhang the whole way from start to finish. This hasn't been that way so far. The first two games, Jiaqi has had big leads. This game, she's down 4-1, but the first two games, Jiaqi's had a lead. She just hasn't been able to pull it out at the end.
Oh, you don't get any better than that. What an amazing rally. Both players pulling out all the stops. Finally, the last ball missing. Easily the point of the tournament, if not the year. These guys are just going at it full force.
Absolutely just ripping balls off both sides, Sean. That was an exciting rally. Now they're going to have to try to compose themselves and get ready for the next point. One thing we talk about with the girls when we do the training camps, all those great points are fun, but they only count for one point. You have to get ready for the next point.
And you see a little bit of frustration there on Jiaqi Zhang's face. She went for the opening forehand. Lily powered it back to the backhand. Jiaqi went to her patented forehand smash. It just went long. And now Lily beginning to open up. A little bit of a lead here in game three. That ball caught the net and went long. Point to Jiaqi, and she'll take over the serve.
You can see, Sean, just in Jiaqi's facial expressions and body language, she knows this game's really important. But she's going to have to give a little bit better body language. She can't make it look like every shot she misses is the end of the world.
Lily staying extremely calm. But this is the Lily Zhang we've known for the last couple of years, winning a medal at the Youth Olympic Games, qualifying for her second Olympics, both London and Rio. And a very nice forehand loop there to again keep that lead at 3 with the serve. Jiaqi just netting that final forehand counterattack.
Jiaqi just finding a way to kind of hang around this game. Starting with the opening flip, she gets into the middle right there of Lily, and then boom, she kind of sets up that backhand flat kill. But it's that middle, Sean, both of them, that's how they're setting up their kill shots.
And Lily Zhang, just so strong from the backhand side. Jiaqi Zheng really needs this point to stay alive. Oh, that ball barely missed. Jiaqi Zheng keeping Lily Zhang in the backcourt with a series of powerful forehand smashes. Amazing how Lily was able to keep the ball in play. 15, 20 feet back. Jiaqi continues to power both to the backhand side and then finally out to the forehand. Lily's ball just misses by the narrowest of margins. Lily with the serve.
8-6.
Ooh, that was a great forehand reaction by Jiaqi there, Sean. Probably saved her game, keeping her alive for a little bit longer. Lily made a great shot out to the wide forehand. These girls are so quick on their feet and with their hands. It's unbelievable how fast the ball is traveling and how they can not only make the shot, but they're actually thinking as the point's going on about where they want to place that next shot.
Wow, that drop shot that Jiaqi did paralyzed Lily, but Lily was able to get back up to the table. What a defensive stance by Lily Zhang. Threw everything at her with both forehand and backhand attacks. Lily stayed up to the table, finally forced the error into the net, and now Lily with 3 game points. And once again, Lily Zhang getting the better of that exchange and has now extended her lead to 3-0 in this best of 7 match.
Sean, you're going to see a lot of quick backhand-to-backhand exchanges. And the longer the rally goes, it favors Lily Zhang. And we've seen her win a number of these long rallies.
So right now, 4th game coming up. Lily Zhang in the lead. Keep an eye on her. Welcome back to Game 4 of the Women's Singles Finals here at the Brooklyn Bowl. 2016 U.S. National Championships. Gold is on the line. Serving Lily Zhang with a 3-0 lead against Olympic teammate Jiaqi Zheng. 0-0, Game 4. Once again, Corey, Lily just coming out so strong, establishing that strong backhand directly off the serve.
Sean, if this lead gets any bigger, you're going to want to look for a timeout from Jiaqi. I don't like her strategy coming out to this game. She needs to get back into locking Lily into the short game with the short forehand. It's almost like she's kind of forgot her tactics a little bit. And she's getting lost kind of in the whole grand scheme of being down 3-0. And it's really important for her to kind of manage things mentally to get things back on track.
There's a nice combination by Jiaqi, both using that backhand quick attack and then stepping around and getting the powerful forehand. Lily off the table. Players tied up at 2 apiece. We're in game 4. This is a best of 7 match. Lily Zhang 1 game away from claiming her 3rd women's singles title. Patented forehand smash by Jiaqi, starting with an opening to the forehand cross court and then crushing the ball down the line.
One thing I really like so far in this game, though, Sean, even though Jiaqi's made a couple mistakes, her mental game looks a lot better than it's been. Sometimes when she gets down, she gets too negative, but she's been very positive with herself, and she's facing a whole lot of adversity, so that's a really positive sign if you're a Jiaqi Zheng fan.
That was one amazing recovery that Lily Zhang was able to do. Jiaqi powered a ball right into the center of the table with that forehand. Somehow Lily picked it up. Now Jiaqi taking her single timeout. She'll have a minute to think things over. Each one of these points extra critical now that we're in the 4th game. Lily will have the serve. Jiaqi is trailing 4-5.
Really smart timeout. Sometimes people wait a little too long before they use their timeout. Jiaqi had a 4-2 lead. Lily gets the next 3 points. I think if I'm Jiaqi, if I was having to coach myself, which is pretty rare nowadays, everybody usually has somebody in their corner to coach them, I would have a little notepad in the back of 3 key things that I want to do in the match in order to win against the whatever opponent I'm playing. I think sometimes players need to read that as like a little reminder, because sometimes you can get lost in all the lights and fans and cheering and stuff like that, and you lose focus of what's important.
Wow. That ball just clipped the net after Lily went for the big forehand smash. Saw her putting her hand up just to signify she knew it did touch the net, which made the timing very difficult. Jiaqi with the serve. And there's that strong backhand opening. We often think of the penholder grip as being very weak on the backhand side. With Jiaqi Zheng, no difficulty whatsoever.
Well, it's the opposite, because she plays with the modern backhand, which is called the reverse penhold backhand. And so it's actually stronger than most shakehand backhands, because it comes off with kind of a weird side spin on it that if you're not used to it, it can be really difficult to deal with. Obviously, it's not much difficult for Lily, them playing at the same club, the ICC in Milipitas, California, and being Olympic teammates. They've been spending the last 2 months together traveling through Europe and even across the U.S.
So Lily with the serve. 6-all, game 4, 1 game away. 7. Lily with a very well-placed side-spin serve.
Really impressive there, Sean, out of Jiaqi. Down, but Lily hangs the ball up there and boom, just takes that and cranks it to the wide forehand of Lily Zhang. I like that she's still confident in her game, even though she's down a little bit. That's a really positive sign.
Stop. Oh, and a very strong backhand attack off the serve. Lily leaning over the table, but somehow managing with her wrist to top that ball. Put instant pressure, a must-win point for Jiaqi. And Lily able to create some space between herself and her teammate. 2 points away from winning her third women's singles title. Oh, and that ball dribbled over. It looked like it was going to just crawl itself. Lily ready for a big backhand. You can see the ball hit the net and jump right by the GoPro camera. 9 serving 8. And Jiaqi up for the challenge.
Wow, what a mental swing when Jiaqi hit that backhand that smacked the net and barely dribbled over. I was already thinking, Lily has a 10-7 lead. 2 seconds later, we're at 9-all, and Jiaqi's still alive. Beautiful redirection there, Sean. Great location on Jiaqi's attacks there, and that's the key. She takes this first ball. Instead of going hard, she plays it soft, gets a weak ball, whacks that ball, and Lily not able to make the block down the line. Really quality attacks, and the most important part of the attack is the location.
And Jiaqi Zheng takes game number 4 in dramatic fashion. 11-9 to extend this best of 7 contest.
Sean, I think if I was going to coach somebody to play the 5th game, is what I would tell them is let the other player get a big lead and then come back and win at the end, because that's how the first 4 games have went so far.
Both these players going toe-to-toe, not giving an inch.
I think in the 5th game, Sean, we may see this match extend out. And now if Jiaqi can come back and win game 5, all of a sudden she gets a little momentum. And Lily might start thinking, oh my gosh, if I would have got out of here 5 minutes ago, I'd be the U.S. national champion right now. But these players are professionals. They're champions for a reason. They've both won this title before. Lily's not going to get that ahead of herself. Is what they're going to both do is they're going to play 1 point at a time and just compete against each other. And that's exactly what we've seen in the first 4 games. That's what we're going to see in this game as well.
And both players have used up their 1 timeout. So moving forward, there's no more breaks in the action due to momentum swings. We've got the defending women's champion, Jiaqi Zheng, in the red. Lily Zheng trying to get back onto the highest podium to win her 3rd women's singles title. Corey, I've never seen these two players have such great rallies in any of their matches to date.
Yeah, and I think part of it is really in the last 2 months, Sean, since they made the Olympic team together. They've been in training camps together, and they've been playing all across Europe in the Pro Tour tournaments. And so they're sleeping in the same hotel rooms. They're warming each other up for their matches. So their game is, they're so used to each other's game now, and I think that's one reason for the quality of points being so great.
And now Jiaqi jumps out to a 2-0 lead here in game 5.
Looks like she's got back to her strategy a little bit too. She made a really nice drop shot to the short forehand. Lily really struggling to get up to that ball.
Net serve.
Lily clearly trying to serve long. Jiaqi's going to have to play some offense on that serve.
Nice combination of 2 forehand smashes. Jiaqi with the opening shot. Lily popping it up. Jiaqi's able to step around. And then one more forehand smash down the line. Lily looking to get on the board here in game 5. Oh, that was one tremendous reach.
You can see the frustration right now on Lily Shine. Just as I was talking about, Jiaqi's putting a little run of her own together. Lily's going to have to settle herself down and go back to playing one point at a time and not think about who's got momentum or the big match swing or anything like that.
Oh, that's just pure power. Both players just unleashing every attack that they have. Jiaqi playing a powerful backhand, dealing with a forehand counterattack that then she picks off the bounce and has now extended her lead to 5-0 here in game five, and she has the serve still. Oh, and she goes for a backhand rip. That ball went off, so it will be Jiaqi's point. Lily went for the quick flip, missed the end of the table.
Main difference here, Sean, is when Jiaqi was down, her body language was still good. She was still positive and still fighting. Lily's starting to let her body language drop a little bit, and there's some, you can see there's some doubt. And you can't do that when the other player is making a run. You have to maintain a positive self-image and portray a positive attitude, giving Jiaqi even more confidence than she already has after making the run in the last game and getting a 6-2 lead in this game.
That ball clipped the net. Little change of spin. Jiaqi's ball goes long. That serve, Corey, looked a little bit high there.
Yeah, it was, and Jiaqi noticed it right away. He gets up and just snaps a backhand. No chance for Lily to react to that ball. Lily's trying to move her serve away so that Jiaqi can't keep getting to that short forehand. Jiaqi's drop shot is one of the best drop shots in the world.
Oh, and Lily set up that ball beautifully with a shot out to the forehand. Jiaqi returned it, but then missing the open court on the backhand side. One to the forehand, and then having it right there. Lily would definitely like to have that one back.
Nine-four, Sean, but this is a dangerous lead. Whoever had the lead in the first four games ended up losing. So I don't know if it's good or bad to be up 9-4.
Turn off that backhand smash. Lily's smiling after that last one. Popped up. She was somehow able to get her backhand to keep that ball in play and then just really went for broke on the forehand counterattack. Now we have six game points for Jiaqi to stay alive in this match. And she goes for that short drop shot. And Jiaqi Zheng has now shortened that lead from 3-1 now to 3-2 with a series of very nice placement attacks and getting her forehand into play. Both players still standing toe-to-toe with their attacks, but Jiaqi Now, with an 11-5 victory here in game five, keeps her dreams alive of retaining her women's singles crown.
So what we've seen so far, Sean, is all the games so far have been pretty close. The last game was the first game that hasn't been close. The first four games were tight, big lead reversals kind of at the end of each game. But Jiaqi has kind of gotten back to what she's been doing with the short forehand. And Lily doesn't really have an answer yet. She's been trying to serve a little bit longer, but she hasn't been able to extend the rally.
Well, we've really seen that momentum. Lily Zheng taking that timeout to secure game one, and then just to run the table and get games two and three. And now Jiaqi, continuing to get that forehand smash in, has won games four and five, and now is trailing, but has definitely found her game and is doing everything within her power to keep that women's singles crown in the Bay Area. Set. Oh, and Lily let out a very loud, exciting sigh after winning the point.
I like it though, Sean. Getting positive, getting back. Get some positive emotions flowing. Really important after dropping the last
two games.
And Lily
matches it with a shot of her own.
And Jiaqi will match it, no problem. These guys aren't out here playing for fun as teammates. They're battling. I mean, this title means everything to them. And Lily, I like to see her when she gets fired up a little bit. That's when she plays her best, in my opinion. And Jiaqi as well. They're usually kind of quiet, but when they're playing for something important, that's when they let their emotions out.
And that ball clipped the top of the net. Just went long. And Lily trying to control that short return. Jiaqi drops it right back. Lily gives her another short one. That ball clipped the top of the net. Point to Zhang. And you can see and hear Jiaqi just continuing to stay offensive-minded.
Yeah, you can certainly feel, Sean, the intensity's went up a couple notches. We're in game six. Jiaqi's going to fight like crazy to make it go seven, and Lily wants to finish this thing and get out of here.
That ball went long. Point to Lily Zhang. Both these players taking every opportunity to get any advantage off those short serves, whether it's flicking the ball or dropping them to a good location. And look at that. Jiaqi Zheng stepping in and then stepping out, able to deal with a very strong forehand attack with an attack of her own right off the bounce, hitting Lily's paddle on the backswing to bring it back to 3-all here in game six. You know, Corey, you said earlier, when they go backhand to backhand, that is going to favor Lily Zhang.
It is, Sean, because Lily has more options off the backhand side. Jiaqi doesn't want to go to Lily's forehand, but Lily does want to go to Jiaqi's middle. So Jiaqi's got more things to worry about during the backhand to backhand rally.
Jiaqi trying to force that so powerful forehand in. After one backhand exchange, here comes the forehand, and then she tries to get that second one. It just goes a bit long. Now Lily with the serve. The small break up 5-3. Oh, that was a beautiful drop shot. Then heavy backhand opening. Lily unable to keep the ball low.
Jiaqi, a little bit early on that spin, had to kind of let the ball fall a little bit lower. timing's hard when the pressure is this much, Sean, especially in game six. That was a big point for both players. Jiaqi down 4-6, but it's still tight.
Jiaqi continuing to try to get that first backhand topspin in. Lily's been so strong at counterattacking the ball. Once again, Jiaqi Zheng just loading up with that forehand. Lily somehow able to get it back, and then one more forehand smash. Jiaqi has really found her range with that forehand kill. And Lily's returning at least one of them generally in each rally.
Is when Jiaqi is really dangerous with that forehand, is when she can take it to multiple locations. That's when she's most dangerous, and that's what she did at that point, which is a scary sign for Lily.
That ball clipped the top of the net. Lily able to jump around. A little misdirection with her forehand. She's rewarded by it with a 1-point lead here at 7-6 in game six. And now Lily has opened up a 2-point lead. Lily now 3 points away from claiming her third women's singles title. That last forehand smash by Jiaqi. Again, when she misses, it generally clips the top of the net. It is so, so tight of a forehand smash. A lucky break. Lily Zheng's ball just climbed over the net after a series of two quick attacks, and now we have 4 match points for Lily Zheng. And one more net ball. Lily Zheng takes the title over teammate Jiaqi Zheng 4-2 on a series of very well-placed shots. Corey, what a performance by two amazing Olympians as they get ready to head to Rio.
No question, Sean. Once these girls take the emotion out of it and they go back and watch the tape, there's no question they're both going to be happy with their performance. Excellent play by both sides, and a congratulations to Lily Zheng. Title number 3 coming her way.
These players just amazing. A series of forehand, backhand smashes. Lily takes title number 3. We'll be back for much more action at the Brooklyn Bowl. Back at the Brooklyn Bowl, we've just seen the women's singles final. Lily Zheng of ICC has been crowned her third women's singles title. An amazing match between two fine champions that will be headed to Rio. We're going to have a chance to talk to Lily Zheng after seeing a couple highlights here.
Sean, you can see throughout the whole match, Lily's goal was to extend the rally as much as possible because she was the favorite. Once that rally gets past 4 or 5 shots, Jiaqi is looking for kind of the short kill with the forehand. You can see here, both girls, one thing they were able to do is play from all 3 distances of the table. They played real close in the backhand to backhand counters. They played some mid distance, and we even saw Lily back at the barrier lobbing some balls. But the overall performance of both of these athletes was unbelievable. They're both going to be happy with their performance. But unfortunately for Jiaqi, only one person gets home, take home the title. And tonight, that was Lily Zheng.
both these players put on a tremendous show. I've never seen Lily from the backcourt like we see her here. Jiaqi is just powering and hammering her forehand. Earlier points in the match where they were just going at it like I've never seen, not giving an inch. Timeouts were taken early in the match. And again, Lily just missing that final point by one shot. Truly amazing table tennis by two teammates who will have the hopes and dreams of Team USA on their shoulders as they head down to Rio.